Once again, the King of Chaos himself, Sir Pat Knight. And with me as always, Captain
Slappy.
Slappy, man. What is going on, dude?
Nothing.
Oh, man. Night. Dude, it's a great night. We have a wonderful reason. If I get you to turn these lights real quick, Slaps, just to any color real quick, just so they're not strobing like that. Reminds me of the first Grateful Dead concert I was at back in the 60s. 63, which is also the same year Declaration of Independence was signed.
How's that?
Let me get these real quick. What do you want to go, blue? Let's go blue tonight.
Let's go green.
Go green? Save the earth?
Speaking of green.
Yeah, speaking of green, and not what you're thinking, not that type of green. Everybody's like, oh shit, they finally did it. I'm fucking flipping
cats out of the bag.
Yeah. No, I got pregnant. No, we actually have some, what is normally a green alcohol, but we got a donation this week from the Frobster, and I got to say that I am really, really stoked about this, okay? So, Absinth. Y'all know what Absinth is.
Some of them don't.
One of them is, that's 138 proof. This one's a 110. All right. So let's drink them real quick, and let's try them out.
You know, this stuff was banned for a long time. A long time.
Mm-hmm.
I think since like 1930s.
It actually originated in Switzerland. It was actually where it came from. Mm-hmm.
You know why they call it the Green Fairy, though?
Why is that?
Because of one of the ingredients or something, the worm.
Wormwood.
Wormwood. They believe
it was an elixir, actually. It was used as an elixir.
Ooh.
You're supposed to take it with a sugar cube, but we can't find sugar cubes anywhere around where we live.
You know, I heard that it has like a licorice taste.
Well, we're going to find out, because here's the first one. I got these 50-50 shot glasses, man. These are kind of cool.
So we're going to do it like a Jaeger bomb.
Pretty much. Absinthe bomb.
Get that absence of courage.
What did you say?
The abstinence courage. Ain't that what it is?
No, that's a ring you get around your finger when you're in 8th grade that says you won't have sex, you slappy. God damn, dude.
After that, you probably won't have.
Oh, man. Drinking you some abstinence is pretty much just like slang term for getting a beater or eat some beef. Like, that's all I can tell you.
Which one do we do first?
We'll start out with the strong one. Let's go. Man up.
Hold up.
Come on, soldier.
Hold up.
Come on.
Hold up.
Come on, Slappy.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
All right.
Here we go. Here's the first one.
All right.
Cheers. Cheers, buddy. The bird. The bird. Laverne. Who's Laverne?
Woo.
Shirley? Shirley, that took my breath away.
Damn.
Oh, shit.
Ah, that fucking burns.
All right.
Yeah, it makes your tongue.
We'd like to thank everybody for tuning in tonight.
We're out.
Sir Pat and I, Captain Slappy.
Oh, God. Probe.
That's strong.
He told me he had something special.
I felt the hairs between my nutsack and my a-hole tingle.
It's like a very strong...
Oh, man.
...mouthwash, like a minty mouthwash.
Oh.
You know how, like, when you do scope or something, you get that fucking numbness on your tongue?
Oh, man.
You know, I can't say that I don't like the taste.
Well, I'm glad you do, because we're trying the other one.
It's a...
Get it up.
Oh, fuck.
God damn you, my friend. The abstinence.
The green fairy.
The abstinence. Your abstinence.
The abstinences.
Abstinence would probably kill you.
No, it would kill me.
It's like that movie, what was it, 40 days and 40 nights?
Yeah. Well, that's why if you ever have to jerk your jerk, you don't use Crisco Slappy. It's shortening. And on that note, let's see if we can't get sick, my friends. Not too.
Goddamn.
More than a feeling, more than a feeling. I see a million like a world. Oh, yeah. Froby, thank you, my buddy. Thank you, our friend.
You know, it burns, but you know, here's the thing.
Alright, dude.
It's not...
That's fucking pissed out of me.
I would say it's better than that fucking blue flame shit.
Uh-oh. Yeah. Oh, man. I'll tell you what, that first one...
This one actually has a taste Woo! Of it.
Yeah, a taste of it. Took my breath away. Oh, my God. Take my breath away. That's what I'm thinking of. Like, I couldn't believe that. That wasn't cool at all.
No.
That first one, that got me, man. Oh, I'm not even gonna lie. The first one kind of choked me up a little bit, Slappy.
God damn.
That is, that's some strong stuff. If you can't, let's hold them up there. See if they can't see them a little bit better. Oh, I can't. I think the light's gonna be in the way. I mean, they're strong bottles. They're very strong bottles. That 138. I'll tell you what, though.
I don't think I'd want to drink. Like,
I'm breathing like a champ.
I have no problem, you know, drinking.
I got snot dripping out of orifices. Can you say that? Orifices.
It's called pre-cum, dude.
No. No, that would be out of all orifices. Got my pee hole. Just saying, man. Alright, you guys, but anyway, you guys know who we are. Unscripted Chaos Live. Sir Pat Knight, the King of Chaos. Everybody's favorite boner, Captain
Slappy.
Not Mikey Seaver, but I could be your boner. Sperm in my nutsack was just like, woo, baby!
You know, he always comes by with something that's fucking hot.
He always orders weird shit. Like, he's the king of finding this shit.
You know, I looked it up, though, man, and, like, this shit's not cheap. Like, it's not.
Check one. Alright, Slappy, we're about ready to start back up. Slappy. Slappy. my god! Slappy, you look like a Spartan! You guys, welcome back all our chaotic friends, listeners, and viewers. It is I, the King of Chaos himself, Sir Pat Knight, and with me as always, Spartacus Slappy!
I like that.
Oh my god, Slappy, you were in some Greek poses. Like, I don't picture you as a guy who knows a lot of Greek poses. Like, what is... I know what it is. You're training for the Greek triathlon against Three Tolo, aren't you?
That's right.
Oh, man. Slappy's training. He's taking it serious.
You know, I'm looking forward to this.
So, if you guys don't know, Three Tolo, first guest, most viewed guest on our show, made some Slappy statements. Slappy had other plans that night, but he produced Three Toe. Three Toe thought he was going to be there. They're friends. Well, shit hit the fan between Slappy and Three Toe. And Slappy challenged Three Toe to a swimming race. Well, Three Toe said, I'm at a disadvantage because I have three toes. I go in a circle. That's an understandable disadvantage. And he got little T-Rex arms. You have to remember this. Three Toe's kind of built like a buoy, like you see out in the lake.
Like a chicken.
Like a buoy. Like, you know, even if you hit it with your boat and it tips over, no matter if it's down for a second, it's still blam. And those little T-Rex arms. So Three Toe said, and this reminded me so much of the Princess Bride movie, Slappy. Three Toe said, okay, Slappy can probably outswim me, but he's no match for my mind. And that's when I thought with a couple other of the Knights of the Round Table, who you will meet on that day, Slappy, select Knights of the Round Table have chosen to come to this event, the Greek triathlon.
Like the little knightlings.
The knightlings have decided to show up in full force. And what it'll be, it will start out with a javelin toss between you and Three Toe. And that will give the first person a 5-second head start.
All right.
You will either drink a beer or take a shot. It's one lap up the yard. After that, you'll go to a minute beer hold in two mugs, filled all the way up. And then your partner, you can't leave until your partner finishes the beer. Somebody has to take the beer. You have to give the beer away.
Okay.
You got a service.
So we got a partner.
You and Three Toe should be good at servicing. But anyway, no, you don't have a partner. They don't have to drink it right there and then. You just pass it off. You got to get rid of it.
All
right. After that, it's a battle of wits.
I got that.
You both recite one sentence chosen by some Knights of the Round Table who remain anonymous because the position's held, who will pick one sentence from a Shakespearean play that you must read with good dialect.
Oh, shit.
And then...
Sober or...
There's drinks involved in every round. Then, after that, you'll have to answer one question deemed third grade level.
What?
Third grade level or under. Question.
You gotta keep it fair.
Yep. And then after that, it's one lap down and back in the pool. And then this beef is squashed after the Greek triathlon.
Because I'll win.
And it's not a triathlon in that event of we're thinking bicycling, swimming. Like Three Toes Low said. It's like you don't trade a Sicilian wine when you're in Peru, you know? I mean, you just don't do that. He knew that you with that Slappy physique look like Slapberg. Hamburger. Look like a lot of hamburgers been in that belly. But with that physique, that he could not keep up with you.
Right.
But intellectually, he thinks that he can act like a... I mean, honestly, Three Toes So said that...
All I gotta do is say,
he's a hooker. He'll blow you when it comes to the mind.
We got a spelling test. Time to spell B.
B. We could spell B today, yeah. But anyway, so this triathlon, the Greek triathlon is the ending episode of season one, and then we're going to decide whether or not we want to do season two. Oh, and also, we're just throwing this up there. We have received no cash apps the whole time that we did this. Whatever we get in cash app after this episode, and I will actually post this episode early so we can have a chance. If I can get it, I'm a Prime member. Whatever we have by Tuesday will go into Three Tolo's swimming trunks. Because after the debauchery that he pulled last time, my wife gets to pick out his swimming trunks.
Oh, shit.
And she doesn't have a sense of humor so much as when...
And he has to wear them?
Yes. And as
no
when,
matter what it is.
Mm-hmm. I'm not... No, he's not doing anything with the, like, the little pointy dome things and stuff. I'm not doing
no,
that.
No, but like...
No, I'll go for, like, a leopard skin thong. I'm not against that. I just don't want anything that's got the, you know, the pecker hole.
So he could end up in some, like, Daisy Duke, like...
He could end up in any swimming trunks. And Slappy, I want you to make some grade A impressions on your swimming trunks, too. Don't let us down.
Dude, I'll get him in a one piece and then, like, get the wrestling.
You know? And here, ladies and gentlemen, Slappy, you didn't even not even know this, but I have something special. This is coming to you. Unscripted Chaos Live. Slappy, you better not let me down because this cannot leave this building. The belt, Slappy. That is the belt. Look at that, Slappy. That could be around your waist. You have to win. That can be up there for season 2. If we do a season 2, that could be there if you can win. That can say Slappy, not three toe.
Slappy.
Slappy.
All the slapaholics.
Uh-huh. So, I mean, a lot of the slapaholics are counting on you right now, man. I mean, three toe made a good point, though, you know. He evened up the odds. He did.
You know, I feel like the only way he would win would be like to distract me with, like, you know, a wardrobe malfunction or something. I mean.
Oh, God, I hope another wardrobe malfunction doesn't happen with him. He already had one. He was like the Janet Jackson of non-popular people.
That was not a Jackson boot. That was like more like...
No, I'm not saying it was a Jackson titty.
Maybe Freddie Jackson.
Freddie Jackson.
Randy Jackson.
Randy Jackson.
Thriller.
Randy Jackson. Oh, man. No, I mean, I can see it. But the thing is, Rito came against it, and he came on common ground. So, I mean, it's going to happen. You guys don't want to miss that episode by far. Knights of the Round Table will be here to man some of the stations. And, it's going to be the fucking best goddamn episode you've ever seen in your life, you guys.
The Greek gods will speak.
We are Unscripted Chaos Live, you guys. Come on, we'll be back in a minute. Sir Pat Knight.
Drunk ass fucking
glass. Yes, take your Spartacus Slappy, but for tonight, you guys, leave it to your beaver hand while you leave it called Captain Slappy. I'll stop the world and round with you. You see the difference, and it's getting better all the time. There's nothing you can do. What is up, all our chaotic friends, listeners, and viewers? It is I, the King of Chaos himself, and with me as always, Captain Slappy. Man, a little modern English, dude. I'll stop the world and melt with you. I'll melt a BLT. Or a grilled cheese. So good. I love a grilled cheese. No, I mean, dude, one-hit wonders are badass, dude. Like,
it could be. Not always.
What do you mean, like, not always? I feel like, I hate when you do that, because you know what it makes me feel like? It makes me feel like it's... Ladies and gentlemen, Fat Fat Popular Man, Unscripted Chaos Live brings to you once again, Story Time with Captain Slappy!
What am I going to talk about this week?
What are you?
Oh, man. Have you ever had... Because you were just playing that one-hit wonder. I was thinking
yeah, one-hit wonders are awesome, dude.
Yeah, I was thinking of something, though. You ever had somebody, friend, relative, or something, ever come up to you and just out of nowhere just tell you the most fucked up thing or ask your advice? More like ask you a question, but in the middle of asking you a question, or they're kind of telling you a story and want your advice, but it's so fucked up you don't even know how to answer.
Is it one of those that they're, you know, it's them, or is it a, hey, a friend asked, you know, me, and I was wanting to ask you, you know, for this friend.
No, it's them, but it's just, oh, okay. it's just one of those.
It's a fucking Doiner story.
Yeah.
Okay, the game chaos has seen a couple of those stories.
So
slap away, man.
You got
slap
a sister, away. So, you know.
Yes.
And I got a sister. I got several sisters. But anyway, okay, so.
You have a sister?
I got three.
Okay.
Well.
Okay.
My dad, they were stepsisters.
Okay.
My dad was married quite a few times.
Stepsister.
So one of my stepsisters whenever I was younger. All okay. Right. So anyway, she was a good girl, you know. I was always the one that got in trouble and stuff like that. Me and my brothers and stuff like that. And she was like always good in school and everything. She didn't really date around. She played sports, and she was dating this one guy for probably maybe about 4-5 months maybe or something like that. I didn't like him. I thought he was kind of a nerd. You know, he just wasn't preppy, nerdy fucking dudes, man. But not really a nerd, like a, you know, glasses nerd. Just,
well, I mean, I can't take away anything from the nerd. But what does Slappy's sister look like? That's what people want to know.
Yeah, we were twins, so she was hot. We look alike.
I get where you're coming from, but that's like a double negative. Like,
man, I know where twins come from. It's like when the left nut and the right nut, they like form together and like they nut at the same time, and it's like the fucking space continuum.
You're gonna bomb in this triathlon, dude.
I got you, dude.
Okay.
I got you.
No, you don't. But anyway, back to your story. No, you don't.
No, we wasn't twins anyway.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
But anyway, one of my sisters, all right. So she was dating this guy and everything.
Stepsister twin.
So she's like just out of nowhere. I'm sitting there watching TV and just out of nowhere, she's like, Bub. That's what she called me, Bub.
Okay.
She's like, Bub. She goes, I got to ask you a question. I was like, what? You know? And she's like, a guy knows, what, don't they? And I was like, that's all she said. Like, a guy knows. Knows what? What? Knows what the weather is?
Everything, motherfucker.
Knows.
Everything.
Knows everything. She's like, God knows. I was like, yeah, exactly, yeah. She's like, I was like, knows what? She's like,
I know everything my wife tells me.
She's like, when you're, like, you know, like, whenever you're getting it on. I was like, hold up, right. What do you mean getting it on? And this is that overprotective brother stage right now. I'm like, what do you mean getting it on? She's like, when you have sex, all right? So now I'm kind of mad. Like, I don't want to hear.
Get to know a boy's boy.
I don't want to hear about my sister, man. Yeah, I don't want to hear about my sister, whatever the fuck she does outside the house. And I damn sure don't want to hear about some fucking dude bonging my fucking sister. I'm getting mad. All right. So she's like,
it was not really.
So like,
it's like you're listening to somebody boing your sister. Your sister telling you about it.
Right. So, like, I'm instantly into the mood of, like, I'm about to beat this motherfucker's ass, and I didn't know who the fuck it is. But anyway, back.
How do you know when a vape cart runs out? Like, it does it not taste like a cigarette anymore?
Pretty much. It tastes like just fucking, like, burnt, like battery burn.
That wasn't even close to 5,000 puffs. Sons of bitches. Anyway.
Here, try this cherry.
That's good. Yay!
Hey, smoke my cherry, motherfucker!
You and your sister are twins.
Motherfucker. But anyway, dude, alright, so I'm getting mad, and I'm like, I'm about to beat this motherfucker's ass, dude.
Oh, shit.
All right. So, anyway, she's like, whenever they're having sex, I was like, alright, I guess, yeah, I know, you know. She's like,
fuck it.
She's like, alright, well, you know, I've been dating Tony, you know, for about 4 or 5 months. Dude's name was Tony.
This shit's good.
I was like, yeah. She's like, well, I finally decided that I was going to go all the way with him. I was like, what do you mean? She's like, well, we've messed around. And my sister, like, she wasn't a whore or nothing like that, dude. Like, like I said, she was a good girl. So, like, I think she slept with one person, maybe, this one dude that she dated. But I guess she messed around with this dude. But anyway, she said I guess she was going to give this dude some or something. So, like, they went to this party that, like, everybody was going to after, like, this fucking sporting event. And they went into this bedroom and shit, and she said that this motherfucker, like, laid her down, you know, and all that shit. And I was like, all right, I don't really fucking care. She's like, no, listen, I got to tell you this. And
but for not caring, you're hanging around listening and my story sister, for a long time.
I had no choice, man. It's like she's just sitting there.
Shut the fuck up, bitch!
Anyway, my sister was fucking tiny, so she wasn't like
Hey,
she wasn't like big, okay? So keep that in mind. So
now, you can not
what are you saying, Matt Howard? Anyway, all right. So she was small, tiny. All right. So this motherfucker, she said, laid her on the bed.
This one's out.
Put fucking the
are
legs
you
up.
Fucking serious? I quit. I don't even really have a religion, so I can't blame it on anything. It's just.
So he put her
bad luck.
He put her legs up and all this shit and everything. Said she, he thrusted. Said she didn't feel nothing. Said he thrusted again. She didn't feel nothing. I'm like, why are you? I don't give a fuck. She's like, no. That's why I have my question.
But that's like, not her fault.
Right, but I mean, I'm trying not. To, I'm trying to.
As a man, if you're thrusted, you should. You should.
But listen to this, dude. So she said that. I'm trying. If I was a girl, man, I'd punch this motherfucker, dude. She said this, said this motherfucker.
That muse right there. The cigar one.
Said this motherfucker had her legs like scissored up, right? Said this motherfucker said, ugh. And then like a rabbit. And then like, ugh. I was like, what? She said, yeah, this motherfucker like deep thrust. And like some fast power. And then like, like a. Anyway, all right. So I'm laughing at this point. I was like, Anyway, said she still didn't feel nothing. Said then this motherfucker started talking shit. Like, yeah, baby, you've been waiting a long time. I'm about
what
to.
Do you, what do you think? Put yourself in the situation of this Slappy. We're gonna indulge on this story time of Slappy. I'm gonna add a little insight. What would you do if you were a woman?
Okay. I would have beat this motherfucker's ass, dude.
You're a woman.
I've been laughing.
You're a woman. You're all laid back. We got to think of this in from a different perspective. So if we do have any lady viewers that they know, we consider their opinion. If you were looking, and there was some guy looking at you going, oh, yeah. What the fuck? Like, you know, like, dudes do that. Like, I will never do anything like that again. Slappy, every time you tell a story, you know what? You're almost like your own religion. And I'm not dipping into this in a religious sense. I'm not doing that. What I'm saying is, every time you tell a goddamn story, it opens up my eyes to a different viewpoint.
That's right.
A side that I've never seen. I will never do that again. You know what? You're like a love guru tonight. Finish your story, Slappy.
Anyway. So, you know.
Guru, Slappy.
Anyway, where was I at? Oh. She said he was.
Hold on, hold on.
Gonna be a guru.
We gotta have the guru-ness.
Guru-ness.
Tell you what, that fucking accident shit.
Yeah. I feel it. I feel it greatly. Is that out? Alright.
Finish with your story, guru.
Where was I?
You're at the part where the dude was in between your sister.
Okay,
she
Anyway, said this dude's thrusting and all this stuff, talking shit and all this.
Maybe it was made for an asshole.
So, she's small. So,
it happened.
She said she felt something weird and everything. And then she said she felt her back getting kind of wet. Peep this, dude. She said this motherfucker had his dick between like her butt. He had her like that. He had his dick between her butt cheek and the mattress. That's what he was fucking, dude. Like, he was
no,
fucking,
he wasn't
dude.
Fucking,
he was fucking the mattress.
Fucking implies a man and a woman together or whatever in this day and age, but that ain't fucking.
So I was like,
motherfucker, that's dry hunting a Serta.
So I was like,
this motherfucker went back to age 13.
Your sleep number is?
No shit, man. Think about this. What if he was like, I didn't do it, and all of a sudden you're like,
dude,
memory foam.
What I want to know, is if he had that motherfucking sleep number underneath 18, you know, it was like, say, 17, and he was hitting that mattress, would it be like matchatory, right?
This is why you're going to lose so fast.
But anyway, dude, yeah, she told me that he was fucking like hitting the, I said, why didn't you like reach up and like put it in? She's like, I wanted to, but she said whenever he was talking about how he was going to just tear me up, said, I let him fuck that mattress for a good 45 minutes.
Okay, what happens like 3 years down the line? All of a sudden, they sell this mattress, and then this mattress comes forward that, you know, 9 months after that, it had a couple pillows.
I don't know, but that dude, man, you know he had been run because, like, my sister had a big mouth, and, like, that motherfucker probably didn't get no pussy nowhere in the
camp. What kind of pillowcases do you use? What color?
What color do I use?
Yeah.
A fucking different color, dude. The pillowcase is a pillowcase.
I like to use darker ones. I feel like they soak in the coldness a little bit better for my...
Like... Black or fucking dark blue or fucking...
Well, in this case with this guy, he wouldn't use those. They wouldn't know who the owner of the pillow was. No, it'd be like a big body pillow, you know?
Right.
What if this guy all of a sudden, man, like, that's his fad now?
But here's
what if it threw him into some weird thing in his noggin, dude, where now he's like... Dry hunching pillows.
Dude, he couldn't understand why my best friend kept calling him motherfucking Poster Petey. Because he kept going... Dude, he kept going around telling everybody, man, I'll fuck the shit out of my killer sister, man. I'll fuck the shit out of him. He's like, what's up, Poster Petey?
He had a three-way with McGill's sister kind of just being there and fucking... Sort of
Petey. But here's the
fuck... sounds like dude, a fucking golden girl.
Here's the fucked up thing, though, man. This dude was so goddamn fucking square that, like, he's like, man, why does your friend keep calling me Poster Petey? I think he's trying to be cool. I think he's, like, got me mixed up. I think he's calling me, like, you know, Petey Pablo or some shit, but, like, he doesn't know the guy's name. I was like, yeah, dude, that's right.
Yeah. Like a pipe of pickle. Big peppers. You know? But no,
how would you not know, though, man? Like, how can you... Dude, I've been fucked up. And still, like, a blind squirrel will find a fucking nut in the yard.
I mean, not if it's nose blind, too.
I don't know, man.
You know, it's just one of those things,
you put like, enough dough on that motherfucker, you will find a wet spot.
Dude, there's bloopers, and that's one. You just hope that, you know... Many men go the whole lifetime without one of those bloopers. And you hope that you're one of those men who make it through that. But, you know, as a man, every man has those moments. Sometimes you just hope they don't get out. And sometimes you hope you're married so you know that they stay right there.
Yeah.
Some weird shit's happened. Yeah.
We keep Froby, I gotta say, we man, your fucking drink yeah, is...
I'm fucked up. I'm not gonna lie.
A little motherfucking
I'm sweating.
Loopy.
I'm sweating.
My tongue's feel still good. Fucking numb.
Feel good. Guys, we're Unscripted Chaos Live. Cash App. Money Simple on Unscripted Chaos Live. Unscripted Chaos Live. Say bye bye. Say bye bye. Say bye bye. And... Captain
Slappy!
Billy! About 2 days. Motherfuckers. Hey guys! Sponsoring us a nice gas station down the road. Love the characters who work at that motherfucker. Hard working, and good selling people. We love you guys. Out of Bud Light.
Yeah, that shit ain't got drunk since episode one.
It ain't get drunk since episode fucking one.
You know, TJ wanted one though.
Tom Jefferson. I talked him out of it. Talked him from Bud Light into a Bonski. Saved America.
You can have that shit.
Oh, man. It's got alcohol in it. We're running low.
We got plenty to fuck it back there.
Oh, man. I'll tell you what, Slappy.
You know, not to interrupt you, but dude got a question.
What's up?
You know, with all the liquors that we've tasted and everything, what do you think still, in your opinion, is you're leaning towards as in the best taste, and then what's your absolute fucking
I don't want to drink another one. I think the liquor off, and here's the deal. I'm not scared to admit when I was wrong. The liquor off in my head was a lot better than it turned out. We've drank some shit liquors and stuff. I think that we should just go to, let's buy a weird bottle, and we'll drink it, just like we did. Because I'm telling you what, I've drank this Absinth tonight, and I'm pretty fucked up.
Yeah, I couldn't imagine having to put that up against anything, because, I mean, it's pretty much like a...
It's good.
It's a sure shot, though, man. It's like saying putting Jordan up against motherfucking...
But here's my thing. How are we measuring? Are we measuring... Like, here's the deal. We got into the liquor off, and this was season one. And like we said, season one started at the garage door. We barely knew what we were doing.
Right.
You can tell we've came a long way. We're still not all the way there, and we're taking any hits, tips. We've got a couple of, like, promotion things that we've got sent to us in our email that were really cool and people trying to help out. And we'll get back with them. We just haven't had the time yet. But we've had a lot of people help, man. Slag has helped amazingly.
A lot.
Comments, you know, Sonic111 has helped out. Frob's donated a lot of stuff. I mean, all the listeners and viewers who tune in each week, like we say, we always want to tell you guys thank you. And thank you very much for making this even possible. You know, we do mean that.
Right.
We try and reply back to every YouTube comment that we get. We try and reply back, tell you thank you. And when we sign it, Sir Pat Knight and Captain Slappy, it's both of us who are... Well, I mean, I don't sign it to Sir Pat Knight and then he types Captain Slappy, but we're both there when we make the comments back, you know? We are paying attention to that.
Right. And, you know, like you said, if we do end up doing a season two, we've got a lot of big things in store.
We do. I mean, we've got some shit, cool shit that we're messing with right now. Green screens and stuff, you know. And like we said, if we do a season two, we don't know yet if that's a definite or not. And like we said, too, remember, anything from now until Tuesday that gets donated into the Cash App, Money Symbol, and Scripted Chaos Live goes towards Three Toe Low's bathing suit. And here's the thing. We will post a short, like, 10-second video, because what we've seen is about $50. Right. I'd say probably $60 with shipping and stuff. If we hit $60, okay?
So if all you people we work with want to see Three Toe in a thong bikini, put him in a thong bikini.
My wife showed me some of the ones she's had in her mind, and they're pretty good. They're hysterical. But the deal is, once we hit $60, we'll make another video telling you, hey, we've hit the $60, don't worry about it. You don't have to any more from there. And we're willing to put in a little bit ourselves. Me and Slappy are. But we can make this possible. Let's try to. I mean, we're going out with a bang. Like we said. You guys, once again, man, everybody who watches, everybody who tunes in, man, A-Dog. I gotta throw out the A-Dog. He watches every week, Slappy, and he is by far the oldest gentleman that we have who probably watches Unscripted Chaos Live. And he loves it. And it makes me smile so big to know that, you know, this dude's a war vet. Like,
right.
Hopefully one day we can have him on the show, because if we do a season two, we'd like to do, you know, our comedy like we always do. But we like to have a couple serious, you know, every once in a while, you know, people on there. And A-Dog would be the perfect person to tell us, you know,
dude, and it's
some
like,
cool, it's a cool historical. We give historical facts. But if you know that they're like, if you see us looking down, they're probably correct. We're reading them. If we're looking up at you, you know they're not fucking right.
You want to know what's really fucked up, though, is, like, I never really thought much of this whenever we first started doing this. You know, it was kind of like, hey, you know, we're going to do this, you know, for some friends and stuff like that. Dude, I was at Walmart the other day, and somebody just out of the fucking clear blue was like, you're on YouTube. And I was like, what? And he's like, Yeah, y'all do like this
podcast
thing. Like I watched it, had no idea who this dude was, but it was cool.
Sometimes I get some comments, and I've got it where I don't see who the subscribers are. I don't want to know. Like, subscribe. I mean, that's all we ask. Watch. If it's not your thing, we understand that. You guys, once again, everybody who watches, everybody who makes this possible. And we're going to end with a damn Greek triathlon. The Knights of the Round Table were who suggested this when we were talking about some things. And they've offered to help. And I will not turn down the Knights of the Round Table.
I want to know who these knights are. I'm curious.
You will see when they come to you. They're knights, dude. They just don't come out.
Right.
But you guys, Unscripted Chaos Live.
Like the little Templars.
Like, subscribe. You guys. Chaos, four-pack night. Everybody's favorite Spartan, going for the goddamn gold. Captain Happy.
Thank you.